Hello all. Right, so basically tonight I would like to give you a little bit information how to solve the cross product, because for magnetic field intensity using the Biot-Savart law, we need to solve the cross product. For example, for cartesian, okay, hopefully you using this diagram, we have the x, y, and z. This is a sequence that you have to follow. Okay, this is the clockwise, so this is the cross product. So if you are following the sequence, so basically the result should be positive. For example, we have the x cross y, you should get z. Okay, and then you have from here to here is y cross z, you got x, and then you have z cross x, z cross x, you got y. Okay, let's say either one of these vectors is negative, so the answer should be negative. For example, the first case. For the first case, so let's say I have negative x cross y, so the answer become negative z. If x cross negative y, the answer become negative z too. But if both is negative, negative x cross negative y, so you got z. Okay, this is for cartesian coordinate. Hopefully this is clear. This is when we follow the sequence, but when we follow the other sequence, the counterclockwise, so this is the direction of counterclockwise, so it become negative. For example, I have, okay, from here, y cross x, you got y cross r into z, or x cross z, you got negative y, and z cross y, negative x. So what happened if I put negative here, so it become positive. I put negative here, it become positive. If I put both negative, it's still negative. Okay. Next, this is for cartesian. For cylindrical. For cylindrical, we have basically the same thing. So, but we have the component that we have is R, phi, and Z. This is the sequence, and the root is still the same. Still the same which what I explained before. For spherical coordinate, so the difference if we have R, theta, and phi. So this is the sequence, right? The same rule apply. So hopefully it's clear, because if the sign is wrong, so your answer will be wrong.